My name is Anthony Merchant. I will make sure that we introduce ourselves. Yes, please.
I'm Michael Panto.
I am an actor and a teaching artist. Where to begin with this? So, I'm sure that you all have noticed, or you have felt the thing, and when you expect higher expectations of your students, that it also feels like you're putting higher expectations on yourself. You're like, oh, well, that means that I have to also do this thing. If I, you know, give whatever it is, if I were to give more tests, I have to grade more tests, or whatever the case may be. I would like to give an opportunity to test so that instead of it being more and more, I'm sliding it over more weight on one side of the teeter-totter so that you have less weight on your side of the teeter-totter. That's what this is about. This is a method I like to call the Herskowitz method, but it is certainly not official. I learned it from David Herskowitz from Target Margin Theater, if you're so interested in looking up that theater, and then a little sprinkled in from Sarah Donke, who is a teacher with NYU and a few other places. But yes, so we're going to start with, we're going to warm us up with a little Shay Shay Kool-Aid. So just to repeat after me, I'm sure some of y'all know it, some of y'all don't, whatever, that's what we're here for. We're here for learning. Shay Shay Kool-Aid! There we go. Shay Kofista!
Shay Kofista!
Kofista la la!
Kofista la la!
La la ki la la!
La la ki la la!
Shay Hayende!
Shay Hayende!
Shay Hayende!
Shay Hayende!
Okay, so now I'm gonna say one and do a gesture. You're gonna repeat the gesture, but you're gonna say two. And we're gonna go to eight. Does that make sense? If it doesn't, that's fine. I don't care. You can't get it wrong, we'll learn. One!
Two.
There you go. Okay. Three!
Four!
Five!
Six!
Seven!
Eight!
Nailed it. Perfect. You're wonderful. All right. Perfect. Thank you. So now we're going to go around the room as quickly as possible. I just want to hear names, and you're going to do a gesture along with your name. So again, if it doesn't make sense, that's fine. We'll figure it out. I'll go first, and we'll go this way. So I might do, and the really important thing as you're learning this, the really important thing is to know that, like, don't overthink this. Literally anything, that's a gesture. Like, literally anything you do. Literally, you just put your hands in front, that counts. That counts. Like, these all, don't be like, what is the most create? Doesn't matter. Just do a thing. Just do a thing. Anything is a thing, do a thing. All right? So, here I am. Anthony. Everyone.
Anthony.
Cool.
Effie.
Mara.
Mara.
Counts.
Rachel.
Yusisha.
Yusisha.
Aisha.
Aisha.
Allie.
Jessica.
Jessica.
Where I'm like, hey, as you're teaching this, it's just how I roll because I know that you're like definitely teachers, but you're also students in this room right now, so like I've got to address both, or I try to. Remember that, sidebar, I think this is a thing that happened because of TikTok, I guess. I'll talk like an old now. I think this is a TikTok thing, but the idea of dance has become, for this moment in time, it will change again, but has become a uniformity of movement. Like, that's how you know you're doing the dance right, is like if it goes the same way, like if it goes exactly the same way, say everyone looks the same. And we're gonna push back against that. Like, my body don't look like your body, and so whatever move I do ain't gonna look like the move that you do, because literally different body, all right? Like, it's just in a different space, and it cannot be the same, right? So, to know that, like, we need to know, and you need to inform your students that, like, whatever it is that they do, whatever that move is, and specifically, I say this specifically speaking to capability, right? Like, whatever you your version of this, if you cannot do that, it's fine. It's still, like, it's still fine on your body, and that move, that's fine. Bless you twice.
Thank you.
Sorry. Nope. For sneezing? You're fine. But, like, that is, the goal is not to make my body look like your body. My job is to make the move on my body. Dig? Yes? Make sense? Okay, I just think that's super duper important, especially as we're going forward, because the whole thing is movement based. All right, so cool. All right, excellent. Now we all have, like, we've done these moves. Wonderful. And I'm going to split you guys into groups. I am going to give you four options, and I don't want you to say your response out loud. Okay? Cool? Got it? Everyone good? All right. Four options. Open would be open, grow, and sky. Got it? Open, grow. That was a three. Open, grow, sky, peace. There we go. Open, grow, sky, peace. Open, grow, sky, peace. Got it? Those are your four options. Have you chosen?
Yes.
Wonderful. Fantastic. All right. If you chose open, hold on, don't move yet. Wait till I do all the things. If you chose open, I want you to go over here. Grow, you're going to go to that side of the room. Sky, you're going to go to this side of the room. Peace, you're going to go to that side of the room. Hold on. Go where you have chosen. Do not be like, oh no, there's not enough people over there. I'm going to switch. Don't do it. Stick to what you chose. Stick to your conviction. All right? Yeah, that's right. Yeah, I see you. I know what the deal is, all right? Cool. Now go to your places. Excellent. I love all of this. I love this for all of you. Oh my gosh, what? So this is
Sky.
Lovely. All right, Sky is super popular. That's wonderful. That's great for Sky. I love that. Now, okay, I'm just gonna give you this assignment. Here's your assignment. Your assignment is to create 8 bars of movement. All right, that is inspired by your word. And the only other rule is that it has to be repeatable, right? So it has to, like, in whatever that means to you, I think of that as, like, well, we can't, you know, you probably shouldn't end with you lying on the floor, unless it starts with you lying on the floor, in which case, then it's repeatable. So, like, repeatable can mean a lot of different things. Just be able to do it in repetition. Yes? Cool. Got it? Does anyone have any questions? Yes? Excuse me, I apologize. 8 counts, thank you very much for that clarifying question. 8 counts. Sorry, as in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 counts. That's it. And you can, like, if you want to use an end in there, I don't know, go nuts, whatever. It's your bars. Or counts. Sorry, counts. Cool. Everyone good? Go forth and create. You have, like, 3 minutes.
3 minutes.
As a group, we're going to put it together. But you're going to bring
it
over to the table. Yes, sir.
Something
of course!
What if this, as a group,
Yeah. So you're having a larger.
again, that's all that that means. So that can be, it doesn't need to be exactly the same.
Okay.
It just needs to be repeatable. And it's like, all right, so if, for example, I have no idea what you guys are doing, and I'm trying not to put too many rules on it. So, but for example, if it were like, I'm going to do, this is my 1, 2, 3, 4, and you're going to do 5, 6, 7, 8, I'd be like, great, just make it so that everyone has a, like, every, we can do that again and again and again. Right?
Yeah.
Cool.
Thank you.
Yes?
So are we starting out or are we starting in?
So like a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I'm sorry.
Oh, sorry, sorry.
I'm sorry, I didn't.
Seems to be in a solid place to start rehearsing, so I'm just gonna, I'm gonna say it out loud, so we're rehearsing now. Go ahead.
Okay, so we're hitting on three.
We're starting on two. Alright, I'm gonna say one more minute of rehearsal. One more?
Let's do what we're doing.
It feels like Sky's super confident. Do we need one more minute or y'all good? How we feeling?
Can we add?
We're good? Alright. In that case, seems like everyone's good. If I could have your attention. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Cool, great.
No, Siri, thank you.
Great. So I would like. I think we should just see. We should all look at each other's pieces. Everyone's in their place. Which group would like to go first?
We'll go first.
Great. Fantastic. What was your word?
Peace.
Excellent. Cool. Can we see? Can
How
we see
many
the thing?
Counts of eights would you like?
Let's do two and see where we're at
okay.
from there.
Okay. Ready?
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. Do you wanna like say a word about how you got to what you got, or like what's inspired anything or not? You can tell me your stuff or you can not.
I think we started with the gestures first.
Yeah,
like,
we started
like,
with
like
all
this,
the
peace like
things we did.
Mm-hmm.
And then we decided, should we end the same or should we start the same, and then where would we go?
I think you said something about adding like little conflict in the beginning and then ending in peace, so like the kind of coming together as a conflict and then ending in peace.
That's very very interesting. That's actually, can we see it one more time with that,
sure.
Now that we all have that influence in our minds? 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's beautiful. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Now,
from smallest to largest, let's see what's going on with Sky.
All right, Sky, ready? And 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I apologize. I was like, oh, I'm slowing down that second 8 count. Cool.
We were a little slower when we were.
Not a problem. On our next go through, I'll make sure that I count slower. That's on me, because 8 counts can be whatever, like, it can be however fast or slow as you want. Like, that's the fun thing about 8 counts, is that you could just start doubling up on them if you want to, right? Like, you could literally just make it, like, 1 and 2 and fine. That's fine, too. So, great. That's why I like to do this non-teacher part of me. That's why I chose to do this time without music, and I was going to add the music later. It is absolutely possible to introduce the music first, if that's what you want to do, totally fine. Just start with the music. Some people learn or take really well to, like, hearing the music first and then creating. I felt like without the music and starting with a word would give you more freedom to create something rather than the music informing. Yes? Just a choice. Just a choice, whatever. It works either way. There's no, like, right or wrong way to do this. It's just an intent. You know, you should just have an intention. Cool, great. So do you want us to give us a word about, like, where we came up with this or how we came up with it, or not? Again, this, I just leave it open to you. But as the creators, you know, if you
we
tell us what you want to tell us.
And then went to
flocking. Flocks of birds.
Flocks of birds.
Yeah.
Flocks of birds. That's delightful. Oh my gosh. Cool. I don't know why I didn't see that the first time. Can we see it again? I'll count slower. Now that we know that they're flocks of birds. And 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's really sweet. I enjoy that. How nice. Oh my goodness. Wonderful. Cool. Let's take it over here. What is our word?
Grow.
Oh, amazing. All right. Let's see how this goes. Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Fantastic. Wonderful. All right. Love that. Is there anything that you want to, you know what I'm really curious about, and again, you don't have to tell me, but I'm really curious about how you, because there's, as I looked around, there's the group with the most discussion about it. So I'm curious as to, like, what was the discussion and how you arrived at what you arrived at. Also because I think that, like, it's very clear that it's growth, you know what I mean? Like, that part's super cool, but so I'm more curious about the process.
All right, so you said A count. I went, for some reason, straight to, like, Motown Temptations and was thinking, like, that Shooby-Doo thing.
Love it.
And then she said, oh, but let's connect it to growing. And then somebody said seed.
Right.
And then
yeah.
Somebody said flower. And then she said we can shoop it all around. And, and then he comes,
like,
up.
Pass
boom,
the energy around
and
then,
right,
send the energy to,
right,
the seed. And then the seed will grow.
Right.
And then that'll be, go, like, we can
so
reverse
like
it.
Like a shoop seed.
Yeah. Oh, we're digging?
Digging.
It was like a
multi-purpose.
Yes, there we go.
Yeah,
there we
exactly
go. Yes.
It was that too.
Yeah, exactly. I also love, and I do want to see this again, but I love the open interpretation. That's why I like to have a little bit of a conversation.
Why are you sorry?
Nothing to be sorry about. You saw something else, and that's
fantastic.
Great.
Yes.
You know, I mean, like, mini soapbox guys, but remember, like, the art thing is that, like, you make art, and once you make it, it's not yours anymore. Like, now it's open to interpretation. So you saw Shovel.
Right.
Oh God, that's wonderful. I love Shovel. All right. That's fantastic, right? And it will, and you'll see where it comes in. It's like, oh, having it be open to an interpretation will allow for these, again, like, spoilers, in case you haven't figured it out. We are creating a dance by means of the telephone, like the game telephone. Like, this is really what we're doing. So getting an interpretation of, like, oh, I saw it as this, is great, because that'll inform something else. You'll bring something else to the table in the next phase, right? Fantastic. Can we see it one more game? 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Great. Fantastic. And I also know, interestingly enough, I know that, and please don't be mad, but please remind me your name. Effie. Effie came to me and asked, do we all have to be doing the same movement? And I answered in the way that I could. I try really hard not to put a hard answer on it, but I know that, like, seeing that, because y'all didn't ask me, and that maybe an idea that you were running with, that there isn't, like, a right or wrong way to do this. Like, you do the thing, and if you follow the instructions, great. And if you don't follow the instructions, great. Because you're gonna figure it out and be like, oh, well, how do I do this now? How do we make that work in the next phase? So, like, that's fine. There doesn't need to be... I try very hard to be like as accepting of whatever comes to the table as possible. So we'll see what comes at the next phase of it, right? Because I specifically told them, like, well, everyone should be able to do the same thing. So, like, I specifically, unintentionally, shut down the idea of there being a solo, of there being one person in the middle, and it was totally unintentional. Not what I went for, but because I didn't know what they were doing. But that affected what happened. So, there's no, again,
no, I'm kidding, I'm
no sorry.
I'm not sorry.
So, last but not least, open? Open.
Okay.
Excellent. Cool. Ladies and gentlemen, open. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Delightful. Y'all want to tell us anything? Tell us anything about it? How we got there?
He started the opening and closing of the hands, and then we were just, I think, thinking about different ways to show this
open.
Image of opening. So then we thought about having all of us open out and the opening of the hands.
Excellent.
Yeah, and the question was about me and Michael doing bigger steps.
Oh, because you're coming
from
further away.
Should we open up like a circle or open up as a line? That was like...
Got you. I'm glad that I didn't shut down the thing that I thought that I shut down. Excellent. Also, when I said no apologies, I'm allowed to apologize. I think it's important, like, as the teacher, right, quotation marks, that it'd be like, you can show fault, you know, and be like, oh, my bad, I was wrong, but it's not, at no point were you wrong. That's on me for not giving enough information. That's my fault. I'm sorry. I lord my sorry over you. So, excellent. That was fantastic. Can we see it one more time? And yes, and then a little bit more of a discussion. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Wonderful. Perfect. So my question is to everyone so far. We are far from done, but I just want to, like, check in at this point. What was that like? What was it like creating something? What was it like seeing the others? Just what was it like? Anyone?
Fun.
Yes, fun. How so?
No, initially I was nervous because I was like, what are we gonna do? Like, how are we gonna think? Like, what do we, you know, I don't know them. What if, you know, I don't know, what if?
Uh-huh.
And then it just started,
it
once
worked.
We started communicating,
right.
It just started coming together and.
Excellent, I love it.
And then it was fun.
Well, it's also that fun challenge of making sure you take everyone's idea,
yeah,
and trying to make it work.
Yeah,
so, like, Motown,
exactly.
Growing, how can we
mm-hmm.
figure it out?
Mm-hmm. Right.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. Yes.
It was a good experience to have. I think right now in my sixth grade class we're focusing a ton on collaboration and, like, what that looks like and what that means and what the challenges of it are. And I think as a drama teacher, like, you know, collaboration is so important for the students, but we don't get to collaborate a lot, and I feel like doing this, I was like, oh, my collaboration skills are a little bit rusty. Like, it's been a while since I've actually had to be in a situation where I had to collaborate. So, like, I found myself doing things that I've been talking with my students about, maybe, you know, stepping forward, stepping back, being open to different people's perspectives and ideas and collaboration styles. And I was like, this is a great opportunity for practice that we don't often get.
Right.
So.
We're usually by ourselves,
yeah. So.
And what about watching it? What about seeing the other groups? What was that like? Or how, yes.
For me, it was, yeah, it
not
was
the only name that I will remember.
It was as joyful experience as doing it. And that, you know, because, you know, sometimes you have students who don't want to do it, and then you say you can observe. And I learned maybe even more from looking. I love that, like, you end it with a breath, which I never thought about, adding a breath at the end. And it's, I love, yeah, the same, collaborating and then observing and discussing.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Love that. Anyone else? Specifically on the observer? No?
I'm glad you said don't try to adjust, because that group was really big. And I was like, oh, good, I do better in small groups. And I looked over there and I'm like, oh my God, I'm so glad I'm not in that group. But I mean, I'm glad, because normally kids end up with their friends.
Uh-huh.
And there's a big group and they can't make it work because they don't know how to collaborate yet.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm always like, just no, stay in your two groups. I'm like, no, we're going to do it together. And they can't come up with an idea. So it's like, oh, children, just listen to what I'm saying right now. So I was very impressed that you actually got it together. Congratulations.
Thanks for... It's funny, I had the opposite reaction, because I was kind of like, we just chose something easy. We were flocking. We were just following. I just had to stand in the back and follow everybody else. Whereas I was looking at the group before, being like, oh, they have to, like, know their choreography. So I was like, I'm glad I'm in a big group.
There was another hand up here, yes?
Yeah, I actually really enjoyed that you had everyone share their piece without talking about how they got there first,
yeah.
And then invited that, like, if you want to share something,
mm-hmm.
And then hearing what people said, especially after seeing it, I was like, oh, okay, or like, oh, I was right, or like, oh, yeah, that works, or, oh, I had no idea that they thought that way, and it was really cool to experience that as
sweet.
A participant.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Okay, so now's my another interjection, you know, the meta interjection as a teacher, right? To the point of separating. That's why I separated on these words.
Mm-hmm.
Another way to do it is, David Hersko is very good at, like, very arbitrary, like, he'll do directions. That's what I started with when we were creating. He'll be like, north, south, east, west, choose one, don't tell me, and go. Or, like, colors, just random things. But it's important, number one, that it's not important, but, like, you're definitely not going for even, you know, and you're definitely, it doesn't need to be, that's fine, you're gonna get different groups, and that's great, and you're definitely not going for, like, counting it off. You're like, no, that's, you have ownership, autonomy, some creative, you got to decide what your color was, and that creates a connection. I'm sure there will definitely be students who are like, you want to be red with me, I'm sure. But also, your connection is that you chose the same thing. Here's your connection, you know, like, oh, well, we do have something in common. We all like to grow. Great. There's some place to start, right? So, like, I think that's, I want to name that. I want to make sure that I, like, point that out, because it is, it's a thing. Great. So now, you're going to hate this. So now, with all of those lovely comments that we said, I would like Open and Grow to join together. I know, what a twist! This is fun for me. It was like a reality show, the reaction to this.
Right.
What's gonna happen?
Yes.
And that means that Sky and Peace are going to join together. And now, and I'm going to be very, very, very loose with what I'm asking here. You are going to create, combine, whatever. Somehow, you are going to come up with 16 counts. Somehow. You're going
to
come up with 16 counts that that definitely combines your two words. Like, inspired by both of your words. Yes? Cool. Okay, go have fun.
Hi.
The only one here. You see how they, this group, they're about the same size, met halfway, and this group was like, I guess we have to go to them.
It was one there too. Interesting.
Repeatable. That's I. That we keep maintaining that it is repeatable. Sorry.
Turns out you guys are
basically. Well, you added someone, so the number is now 11.
There was 10 originally, now there's 11.
That's a shame.
So hold on, so it's gonna be slow count, let's count it out slow. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
So what if,
now what, do?
What if we did
back in
7
and out?
All right, y'all, I'm gonna say you got 2 more minutes. Make sure you get your rehearsal time in.
7, 8.
Yeah.
But then we have to, no, we can't cover them down
so,
on the one. That doesn't, that's
no, we have to bring them down on the one. So what if we just 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we're like that.
It's gonna be wrong. Oh, we're fired. Nope, it's fine. Cool. I'm only pressing, well, two things. Number one, I'm pressing on because I only have so much time with you. Number one. Number two, I'm pressing on because, you know, again, something will be wrong, and that's fine. That's totally fine and great. Maybe something will come of it. That's gravy. All right. Cool. So, who would like to go first? Great.
Someone's feeling Spartacus. All right.
Ready? I will count. I know that I will try to go. I was going to ask how about where should I be counting pace wise?
Slow-ish.
Got it. And that, again, I do apologize because especially in these, I run really, really quickly. So I apologize. I will slow it down. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4.
No, no, I'm just saying that was like such a beautiful melding together. It was lovely, honestly. It just was like, it felt like I wanted to add music and just keep watching it. It was nice. I felt it.
Cool. What? Any other like feedback? And also, I want to open it up to you guys. You want to talk about how you got there? Like, how did you meld these ideas? How did you get there?
Yes. They felt sorry for me and they kept me in my little group.
That's valid. That's legit. That's absolutely valid. I mean, there are so many different ways. That's why I'm so hesitant to put, like, any rules on this. I try to be really broad. There's so many things that can inform what you come up with, right? You know, like, that, if that was the reason, and I doubt it was the only reason, but even still, if that was the only reason, and go, like, you still came up with something ridiculously beautiful, all out of, like, let's make sure that she feels safe, comfy. And that's great. Like, that's fantastic. That's totally fine. Yes.
Yeah. I feel like we didn't overcomplicate it. I mean, we kind of kept the integrity of what the individual pieces were, but where we found moments of overlap, I feel like that's kind of, that was sort of the, you know, stir fry.
Yeah, whatever. You guys keep walking right into the thing you're going to hate next. It's great for me. Yes.
After there were 10, we all became doves and we were birds of peace.
Yeah. Lovely.
I feel like it was a little bit of a struggle this time around because the first time we started with nothing, I had like no emotional attachment because there was nothing there. So I was happy being like a listener, but then this time around there were a lot of cooks and a lot of people were throwing out ideas. We had to keep like refocusing ourselves because people would throw out two really good ideas at the same time and it would get a little bit confusing, especially with the bigger group. So I think like the first time when we did it, Sky was done in like 2 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
But this time we had to use the entire time to figure out the pieces. And still at the end, like, we never got to finish what exactly our official ending was going to be. And I think people had different ideas. I mean, it came out beautiful, but it was harder to collaborate for me.
Interesting. Just walking right into it. It's amazing. Cool. Thank you very much for that. Can we now see this combo? Combo. Especially knowing that
we have to
move on. Ready?
Okay.
Five. What tempo-ish? Where are we at? Slow-ish?
Same
tempo.
Medium-ish.
Great.
Medium.
Also subjective. Five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What was that like to see?
There's like a center to both of these pieces, like a kind of commonality, I guess.
I don't know if I'm jumping ahead, but I want to see like all of us together.
Yeah.
Just because it is similar.
Yeah, that's totally what's
going to
happen.
I'm not like, oh, wow. Sorry.
I mean, y'all were dancing. Y'all were dancing real close to that bush anyway. Like, it was going to happen. It was going to happen. Yes, 110%. And I'm going to make it hard. Anything about comment on like the creation of it?
There was a lot of exchanging leadership, leading and following, and a feeling of trust.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that kind of what comes out watching us, I felt like there is an ensemble, they follow each other, feel trust, the positivity, and also your words were so smart to be all positive. I think that
it comes out of it.
Open and grow is a nice thing.
Mm-hmm.
So we all felt nice. And also being around people that love what they're doing, I felt nice. And that was like very spinning into it, focused, feeling comfortable with each other. Everything was just so perfect.
I know. If only it could be like this every day. Like,
can I have a class like this?
No, just to add on to that, I felt like we were doing a lot of yes and work.
Yeah.
And I felt like
mostly.
There was a balance of voices from both groups. So it wasn't just like one group saying, this is what we're doing. And yeah,
I think a couple
nice.
Of us were louder than others.
Yes.
I will absolutely say that. But I do feel like everyone was agreeing. And if someone had like a change or something, it was like, we'll absolutely
we
take
really
that in. So,
building off
yeah, absolutely.
Just interesting to note, me and our illustrious cameraman did note when Peace went to join Sky versus when Open and Grow went to join each other, Open and Grow met halfway as they were similar sized groups, and Peace was like, I guess we have to go to the
They're making peace.
I'm just pointing it out.
It could be the number.
I know, I'm pointing it out as a thing worth noting, all right? Cool. So, justify it however you want, whatever you like. So now I'm going to do exactly what you said, except I'm going to make it harder because you still only have 2 counts of 8.
So, we're going to combine once more. You have about 5 minutes to come up with two counts of eight and make the whole thing work. Dig it? All of
you.
Yes. Well, I mean, with the all of you as people. Yes.
Well,
go ahead. Come on. Come together. Come together, y'all. Talk it out. Work it out.
And our two seeds in the middle, just see what it looks
seeds,
like.
Okay.
Seeds in the middle of peace.
Yeah, seeds in the middle of peace.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. No, no. Now, what we did was, like, we changed ours to have all of our hands come up and kind of plant the seeds and go down as just a starting. And I noticed that with peace, you guys are doing some kind of turn and, like, bumping into each other, right?
Yeah.
Like, turning.
I sure don't want to bump into the seeds.
No, but if they're going down, you don't
down.
Have to worry about
we'll
that. You don't have to worry about
they'll
that.
Be down.
They'll be down.
So you have to... smash the seed down into the ground.
Right.
Push it good. Make sure it's planted.
Should we see what this looks like first before adding this?
Yeah.
Yeah. Why don't
okay.
we start with like
layer.
A slow count? Like so 5, 6, 7, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That is beautiful. Sorry.
Wow. Are they staying down the entire time?
I think we should probably bring them up. I think.
Maybe,
yes.
I think they should come.
What's the flock movement?
Yeah, maybe the shoop and the flock can go together.
That's
it. Ooh.
Okay. Like a oh, like a wave around the circle.
Like this.
And then turn.
Yeah. They all follow each other. Yeah.
But that down motion could be
that's
a shoop
kind of
and a turn. Maybe at the same. Can we add like a shoop to that? Whatever.
Yeah.
That is.
And it also binds
okay.
up whole
so
thing.
Shoop and turn. And then turn maybe.
Oh, I have an idea. What
yes.
if instead of starting at the center? What if the inspiration comes from the outside, inside?
And
then
in.
Does that make sense?
So, we,
then
so the last count, they do the last count of eight
yeah.
instead of the first count of eight?
Yeah. So the seed
and
is
so we, whatever
I
we
know.
Do on the outside has to be the count of eight, and then they finish on the inside on that eight.
So then maybe,
maybe.
When you guys come out to your peace position, that's when the seeds grow.
Yes.
Right?
Maybe.
Is that what you said? Yeah.
Mm. I do also think we don't have to do eight and eight separate. We can merge them like
yeah.
how they just
yeah.
did.
So at the same time, they're happening all
yeah.
at the same time?
Or like
yeah.
we do the count of eight, but on our count of five, they join their, like, they join.
What if the people on the outside who did the flock do the flock movements and the people who did the seed movements do the...
The shoop.
So we all just keep what we did?
I
and
think
just
so.
Add it
around. We'll be in... doing it concurrently on
the
outside. That way,
heads up, you have two and a half.
That way, the count's
happening.
Then
we need to.
So
then we need to
organize ourselves.
Organize ourselves so that we have all around the.
So like stagger. So stagger the shoots and the flock.
Shoot,
hold up your hands. Where's shoot? We gotta stagger ourselves.
Get in
there
a
lot
right
now. Get in between.
We're just still while you're doing the first count of eight.
And we had done it in groups of two or three staggered around at the same time to kind of keep it all moving. So, you know what I mean? Like groups of two or three doing their flop or their shoot at the same time.
Let's run it.
Where is it going to start, though? In the middle?
One,
so who's starting? You want to start
so
over there?
Still
so she's going to start it around.
Me. Correct? Yeah.
Okay. It has to get all around on an eight, and then they have an eight. So
got it.
Okay, let's try it.
Start from the outside.
5, 6, ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, go middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, go middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, go middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, go middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, go middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, go middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, go middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, go middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, go middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, go middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, go middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, go middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, go middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
Cooper box you 30 more seconds.
Does the outside circle stop after our eight and go back down,
like,
or do we keep doing our moves?
I kind of like the stop, because then you focus on the other things going
not
on.
Not too many things happen.
And
stop
and
from
I think,
back
to where we were
in
the
third.
Yeah,
stop.
Like
you
should
have
been
free. All right, so you were out of time. I would say rehearse it. Rehearse it one more time.
Or
second count of eight, the flockers do not
thank you guys.
See, or some of you, yeah, of course. Some of you had a better vantage point than others. What was that like? Oh my gosh, you're so loud. Please stop.
I'm unnerved. Yeah. You felt a little unnerved or anxious.
Anxiety inducing?
Anxious. Together. But once we started making the focus,
someone said, I think it was you make up a big circle. It looked like that's a circle up first.
Sure did.
And like
yeah.
be able to
that
see each other and start to throw it in. Yes. So that I felt was helpful.
Yeah.
I feel like sometimes these conversations on like leadership are kind of triggering. Not so much for me, but I feel like sometimes students they get fussy over who's got different personality traits.
Yes.
I did like this exercise with them, like a team building thing when I had them working on a team related thing. And I compared their, I gave them sort of like types of people that, or types of roles that they could be. I used the Ninja Turtles. I was like, the blue one is the leader. The red one is like
the
muscle.
Did you call them the blue one and the red one?
Nah, they knew the names.
Okay,
I mean,
good.
This was culturally responsive. Like,
okay.
They know Ninja Turtles and they're speaking their language and my language too. You know, like but you know, that as well, that part didn't really make its way super in. But my point is that like, I feel like I'm comfortable taking a leadership role. I know that there's other people who are not that comfortable doing that, and I feel like that is like okay. I think it should be okay if like you're not like a particularly vocal person, but I think it extends and extrapolates the whole stepping forward, stepping back thing. I mean, like you clearly like started things off, but you like passed the baton. I don't feel like anybody became
overly
dictated.
Yeah,
leader.
I mean, I was like really listening to what you said before about that previous experience. I mean, like I agree with you, but I felt like there were moments where I was just like okay with debate. Like I was fine with it, you know, but I think it's just everybody has a different.
I see hands. I saw that you wanted to say something first, so you're first. Go ahead.
Thanks. I just reflected. I did not speak, but I reflected that it was a nice adding on of ideas. Like I really felt like people kept adding to each other's ideas, which
mm-hmm.
doesn't always happen.
Sure.
That was fortuitous.
Yes.
I think the time element was really helpful because like when we did the circle thing and like one person came up with the circle thing and then somebody came up with alternating and then somebody said, oh, let's make three circles. And because we were like, okay, you have 1 second, it just was like, okay. I mean, there was no debating about it because we just had to make a decision right that second.
About the time.
Hold on, hold on.
Yes?
Because I had similar things. A part of me was just like, stop talking, just do it, right? But which is great at certain points, but then when nobody knows what's going on, it's a hot mess.
Right.
So finding the balance of just do it, but also like,
mm-hmm.
what are we doing?
No, that gave me anxiety because I'm like, I need to know like exactly what's going on. And so there were a couple moments where I was like,
yeah.
who's starting, which direction
say,
are we going?
So wait, what are we doing?
Yeah, what are we doing? Like, and it was like.
And then you said, I'm following you. I don't care what's going on.
But then it strengthened those moments
yes,
where you're like,
did.
Okay,
it
I
did.
Need to like let go of control for a minute and just observe and keep it moving. Because when you stop, that's when the eyes go to you. But fake team.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
I also kind of stepped out of it and thought about my students where if this were to happen, like we're a bunch of theater teachers, educators, but like I could totally see the student being like, no one's listening to me, I'm not gonna do it. And just kind of like stand there like, I'm so confused and I'm anxious about what's going on, I'm just gonna stand here and look like a fool. And then the teacher acting like, well, why are you engaging? Like, let's go, 5, 6, 7, 8. But, and we all, you know, we're yes anding and we're going with it. But I wonder about time and all of these restraints that we're putting on ourselves that we kind of work with, but how our students would see those as challenges and step back versus like, I guess, building that environment where they feel welcome to at least try or join in. So just food for thought.
Yes?
Yeah, I just wanted to like lift up the comment. What was your name? I'm so sorry.
Me?
Yeah.
Jordan.
Jordan, exactly. But Jordan was talking about leadership. That just like, I just wanted to lift that up because it stuck out with me as well. Like, I feel like I'm someone who talks a lot, which is why I'm talking now probably. But I try to like step back. But in these situations, people do need to take, it's too many cooks in the kitchen, right?
Yeah,
so it's
yeah.
like you do need to take, someone has to say something or we, and like yes, the yes ending.
Yes.
And I guess I'm just saying that because I'm not sure what, how do you navigate it and for our students too. So it's just
right.
an interesting like,
I feel like the old is
something
that well
to plug in, and yeah.
Some people were kind of laid back and listening,
mm.
and then some people waited to see if they should step in and say
right.
something, and then they did. So I felt like the overall vibe was really good
yeah.
in terms
yeah.
of sharing the responsibility.
Trust
yeah.
is a big
right.
part of it.
Right. Right.
For
yeah.
me, like being with a bunch of, being with all of you, I kind of like took some time off.
Yeah,
like how often do I get to do this?
Yeah, like, your mark, say your line.
Right.
Right.
How often do I get to like tell me, you know?
Yeah.
So for me, that was the whole experience has
yeah.
been like that.
I won't
trust.
Wanna,
yeah.
Sorry, I didn't
yep.
get shut down. I just want to make sure that
yeah.
you had your
no, it was kind of just said, but I think there were just like levels of leadership. Like I felt like I had a micro level of leadership. I didn't say anything, but I had to use like my observational skills only and rely on the people next to me. And I think that like we kind of had like a little like, we were watching each other over mm-hmm. here, right? And I didn't necessarily know what was going on the other side of the circle, but that was like my participation in the leadership thing. But I think that's very hard for students to do. And like, there's a few D75 people in here, mm-hmm. D75 person, and like something like this without having a clear, this, you watch this person, this is challenging, but it was nice to be that participant.
Did I see a hand over here-ish? Yes.
I'm not sure we're going into this, but I was trying to think of how does this connect to the high expectations.
Oh, this is, oh, sorry, yes.
Yeah?
Yes. Yes, 100%. Yeah, we'll, I don't know, yeah, we'll kind there, of, yeah. We've kind of, like, we've slowly kind of transitioned into the feedback,
okay.
which always happens when I teach these. But yes, so, and I've not told you, this is how I view this. And sorry, I know we have a comment over, there we go. One second. To me, the way that I see this and facilitate this, and this might be like a oh kind of thing, is like this is the kind of thing I believe that you should only or can only teach once and then send them away to go do on their own, where you're like, you're gonna come up rather than having to worry about, like, if we're directing a musical, let's say, and I have to worry about what am I gonna do with the 10 students who like are in the chorus line. I don't want them to be here all day. So like, what am I gonna be like, hey? And it also helps kind of to your point of like, who is out of the room? You're like, well, if I'm dealing with my leads, who, let's be honest, tend to be the more outspoken, it needs to be this way, blah, 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 people, right? Am I right? We've all been in the theater. We know those people. Some of them are in this room. So rather than it having to be that, you can give a group of like 10 students who are all the kind of person, like, I don't know if anyone's listening to me, be like, yeah, you know how to create a thing now. Like, you know how to create choreography on your own. Everything counts. Come back and show me what you got. Thus, taking work off of your plate and putting ownership on them while still maintaining a high expectation. Expect you to come back with 16 repeatable measures so that like we can put this together. Also, this is where I'm going with the reason I don't remember who commented on it. Effie, it was you. Only name I'm going to remember. You commented on the words that I chose, right? In that sense, I go like, you can take, again, I'm going with musical theater, but like, you take a song, be like, well, what is this song about, right? And you come up with four or three, whatever. You come up with like words of what's the song about, and baked in from the beginning, you're gonna get choreography that is gonna be like, oh yeah, that goes with what that song is, right? Like, I don't know, this could be this could be the choreography to The Sun Will Come Out Tomorrow, could it not? Totally, right? And you're like, oh, yep, that works, there you go. And you could like, and you could find a way to put it, and you find a way to utilize everything that's been made, and you have a language that has been created in the room. Everyone remembers this move, and like even if it got cut at some point, you're like, oh no, there's a great place to bring it back,
yeah.
Because we've created a shared language together, right? Oh yeah, no, this is working on a lot of levels. There's a lot going on. Yes.
You kind of cut me off. I was
sorry.
I'm not sure if you're gonna get there, but let me tell you where I see it.
I'm sorry.
And it's totally fine, because those weren't even what I was necessarily saying. So I appreciate that. I was saying the high expectations, one, someone mentioned it, like how you set us up in terms of setting up the community. Although we are theater teachers and we have been in ensembles, we aren't necessarily an ensemble. We created it really quickly with just our names. But by you saying like, whatever you do, whatever you create is beautiful, whatever you're creating is great, those are already expectations for us to meet. Like, we have a performance, we know that, we're gonna meet that expectation. We all have the desire to create something and present something, so we're all working on that. Then our high expectations for our students also is like, I'm setting you up, I know you're gonna perform something. Whatever it is, it's going to be great. So knocking down the high expectations is actually building the high expectation. So thank you.
That was good too. I'll say that. Let's do that one. You had a comment, and then yes, FESE.
No, I was just gonna say, I'm just like proud of all of us for doing that. I was thinking about my students, and I feel like I could probably work with them in the first round in a small group. If I ever had any of my classes try to do something like this, it would be a hot mess.
Yes.
So like,
but
I am
beautiful.
Just proud. Yeah, well, I don't know. I'm not sure. I don't know. But like this, I just have to say, like, how nice to be working with people with that yes and just like we did it. Like it looked cool and we put that together. So I'm just proud of us for doing that because I can take a piece of this and translate it. I know it would turn into arguing and, you know, that person being bossy and blah, 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 blah.
Sure,
like
sure.
They wouldn't create anything.
But you get to yes, but. You get to decide who you're handing that over to. I love proof. That's why I teach theater and not anything. I love being able, because I'm bad at math. Because there's another way you can prove something. But like I love being that moment of I always think when I teach, like I'm teaching comedy or this moment in the Guthrie where this woman was a dancer. She's so sweet, wonderful, and she was going to open this door in this play, and she would take three steps to open the door, and I could see her. I could see her dancerness being like, one, two, three, four. And like, and it was not that performed, but I clocked it, right? And I was like, hey, we're kind of in a comedy, which means that it has to be three. Mm-hmm. And I was like, and I'm just telling you, at this, I'm telling a story to tell a story, so I apologize. But I'm like, it has to be three. I do know why. It's because of pattern. And our minds love a pattern, and three is when you can decide if a pattern is made or broken. I hope you guys are writing this down. It's gold. because it, like that's our minds go like, oh, I saw the pattern, or it disrupted the pattern. We love three. So I was like, I told all of this to her. I was like, it wants to be one, two, then open the door. That will get a laugh. And then I did it, and she's like, and I was like, look, I told you the magic trick. I explained it to you. I did everything, and yet you still laughed at it because the trick works, right? Like, it's a good trick. It works. So to that point, I go, hey, maybe not the first time, but you always get to decide who's doing this. So if you go like, hey, you three, I want you to go do a thing, knowing that those three aren't going to have a problem, and then with the bossy one, you're like, well, see that thing that they made, then all about listening, like, I don't know. I proved that it works. So, like, maybe we need to take a step back and see what's going on there, right? I also think that, depending on the circumstances, that, like, I think you get to manipulate what that group is. It doesn't necessarily have to be, like, everyone, we're doing this, because maybe if you did that without coaching, depending on your class, but most likely, you're going to have someone be bossy, because that's just personalities of students in the room. Ain't nothing wrong with those people, but that's how you're gonna get people taking over versus being like, hey, who needs to step back? Who can do this? Blah, blah, blah. Yes, Effie. Sorry, Michael, this is also, I'm gonna turn it over to you for the feedback after this.
I just wanted to say something about, remind me your name.
Charity,
about, I just clicked in my mind about high expectations. I got a tip from a teacher, it's not my idea, how he keeps everybody to high expectations. So when many times we put groups to work and do that, some students are not gonna do it. They're gonna walk around. Or they're gonna sit down, or they're not focused. So I would see in his classroom whenever he would do a collaborative discussion. By the way, talking about teachers, how many times we do all Monday PLs? They're giving us a prompt, and we're in a group with teachers, and we talk about other things, like, because we don't really like. It's not like this environment. It's not. So we are also the same. So I was asking, how do you keep them so much accountable? And they're all turning and talking about whatever you ask them. And he said, at many points, I say, okay, pause. Please tell me, what are you talking about? He's pointing at students. And whatever they say, that's their grade. So active listening is powerful. I chose to not say anything. I chose just to listen. And for me, it was so enjoyable because I like just thinking of today. I just want to do it and more listen. And I felt so empowered by understanding and getting all this information around. And I felt I was so participating, I was so focused. So many students, they don't realize, they say, you know, I don't know what to do. Why are you gonna participate? I don't know what to do. The next thing you say, okay, you can offer some ideas. And then there is a power struggle. But many times, they think that just sitting there is not okay. They have to keep talking or writing something, or they have to draw something. That means participation. But active listening is powerful, and we have to value that and say, okay, they say, I see you're doing it because we're hands-on. Please tell me what everyone is talking about.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And show that, you know, that's how you can keep high expectations from the silent ones. In my school, many kids are very silent. They don't talk. So I don't want to give them a bad grade because they're not talking. Mm-hmm.
yes, and to that, I go, I mean, I'm just going to call it cheating, but, like, cheat.
Like, if there are those people, if there's students that you're like, oh, they're going to go away, or they're not going to feel like they're going to go away in that, you know, metaphysical sense of not paying, you know, being like, oh, no one's listening to me, whatever. Like, going back to that thing about shared vocabulary, it's like, take that thing that they made and be like, I really liked that. That was, can you show us that move again? Like, cheat. If you get to tip that scale, you get to give it validation. It's just, you know, how many plates can you keep spinning? But you get to be like, no, I really like this thing. Can we find a place for this? I really like that. I think this needs to be there. Let's find a way to incorporate this. Whatever, you get to do that. So, right, you like validating the people and you know, not putting anyone down, but like validating the people who are there and say, you're saying, yo, that work was like, that was important. I see that. I see what you did. And even though you may feel like the group isn't listening, I got you. I got you. That was awesome. All right.
You did that, Anthony. You did what she said. You went around and you said to us, I know you said it to us, and you said to everyone, you said, so what are you talking about? Like, how is this coming along? And then we were forced to kind of tell you what we had so far, which kept us engaged and kept us on our toes. And you did an example of just that. So